Hi everyone, it's me, Jill McKay, coming to you from my studio in Fort Collins, Colorado. So this is a pre-recorded broadcast because, as you know, I'm traveling and will be gone for over 2 weeks. So I just want to make sure I had some good content to stream from wherever I was because it's almost impossible to take everything with me. Travel, visit my kids, and make stuff. So I used to be able to multitask like that, but not as much now. Anyways, I'm pretty excited about today's project. It came out really nice, and you know, you just never know. I had to figure a few things out, but I did, and let's show you what I'm talking about. So we're going to be making this earring. And I'm making this into a kit. So if you buy the kit, you get everything you need to make a pair. And these are really nice findings. And they just, it's a really sweet earring. It looks great on as well. So let's go over what you're going to get in your kit. And that will be, let me see here. So you're going to get two of the earring. So these are Diamond Duo, and I'm calling them earring findings because I'm using them as earrings. And the actual name of this is the Kippos 2. So there's that. And then these are really great little connectors that work with the Diamond Duos. You sew them in, stitch them in line just like any other diamond do. Of course, you're going to get enough. And this is what is the name? Let's look at the name of these. Is Matubo Gem Duo Backlit Purple Haze. Wow. For those of you my age, you might recognize that name. All right. And then you're going to get two of the earrings, the actual ear wires. Sterling plated, and I'm going to be using Wildfire or whichever brand that you use, just so it's strong and it will go through all of these enough times. Going to be getting 0.75 gram of the Toho galvanized silver 11Os. Let's see, anything else? I think that's it, guys. So let me get this out of the way. Oh, no, and you're also going to get two sterling silver 24 gauge wire 4 millimeter jump rings, okay? And that's to connect between the upper part of the earring and the lower part right there. It's a perfect size, not too big. Okay, so let's get started here. Get some things out of the way. I'm going to take about 18 inches of my thread. I always go to the back of the scissors where it's less used because your cut can remain sharp. Wildfire is hard to cut. Or fire line, or whatever you call it. I use more than one brand. So I'm going to get the tip of this wet. I'm going to pull it way down to where I can just barely see the tip of that thread. And then I've got my 10 long beading needle, and I'm just going to press it right on top, just like that. Super easy. Now when we're going to be starting on this component here, and it is a little wobbly in the beginning. Okay, so I'm going to lay out my super duos top to bottom just like this, and you'll see why here in a minute, because you're going to need to add them on in a certain direction. Okay, so I'm picking up my first, I think this is called a, I just cut that Cleftico Yeah, clefticos, which I'm just calling them connectors, okay? Or, yeah, connectors, because, so I'm going from the hole on the left to the hole, and there's a right and wrong side to these. So this side is flat, and this side is rounded. So you want the rounded side facing front, pulling my thread through, leaving about 4-inch tail. And now I'm going to pick up, one of my diamond duos, and I'm going to pick it up from the bottom left corner, okay? So this diamond duo seems to have a plugged up hole, huh? How about that? Nope, it's there. Okay. So we want this to lay right up next to the, just like that, okay? See how well that fits together. Let me zoom in here for you. There we go. Then I'm going to pick up another one from the bottom left. I want these all to lay perfectly together. And now it's time to pick up one of my Klepto connectors. And we're going to go, I've got this facing with the loop down, which is what it's going to do. And I'm going to go through this, okay, just like that. Off we go. So far, so good. Now, we're going to shift around a little. We're going to need to go top right, okay? I'm going to pick it up here. Top right. Let's make sure that is right. Oops. Get everybody facing out the right direction. Yep, top right. So I'm going to pick up my last one. Top right. Go through that. Bring it down. Okay, so we've got them all on there. And now what I'm going to do is go back through all of them. Right now, I've got them facing in different directions. It doesn't matter. We just need to get through all of those beads and connectors. Okay. Now, okay, went all the way around. Now, what we got to do is turn this into a circle. We got all the beads facing in one direction. Let's get them facing pretty side up for the tutorial here. Okay, and then we're going to pull, I'm going to keep them laying correctly, and I'm just going to pull, holding on to them, I'm going to pull this together, okay? Pull on one strand, one side, and then the other. One strand, and then the other. What I'm going to do then is I'm going to make an overhand knot with my tail and my working thread. And I'm going to really pull that all the way together, okay? You don't want it too tight. You don't want it to pucker. But at this point, it will not lay properly. It's still wonky. But I'm going to go ahead and tie one more overhand knot so I can get rid of my tail. We're going to go back through these to reinforce. So, okay, so there's one knot. So that's our second knot, okay? And this is what we have. It's pretty. Let me get my thread zapper. Well, it was right here. What did I do with my thread zapper? Well, I can't seem to find it, so I guess I'm going to have to use scissors. I'll find it later and get it nice and... So there's no extra thread showing. It's just odd. I was just using them. You know, I just wander off sometimes. All right. So we're coming out of, we've tied a knot right here between the gem duo and the connector. So I'm going to go ahead and move through that connector piece, the metal component here. Got to get your needle down in there. Okay, just like that. There. Pull that through. Okay, now's where we're going to start adding some beads, okay? So I'm coming out of the left lower of the Jim Duo, and I'm gonna pick up two of the Toho 11O silver seed beads, okay? Now, I'm going to leave my thread go over the top of that Jim Duo, and I'm going down in the top hole, okay? The outer hole, just like that. And then I'm gonna pick up two more, and I'm gonna go through the next hole on the top, like that. Just adding some beads here. Now I'm gonna pick up two more, and this time we don't have a top hole to go into. So what I'm gonna do is once again work my needle between these two beads here and go through the hole of that metal connector, okay? Just like that. So we're coming out here, we're going to pick up two more, and then we're going to go to the top hole that's waiting for us right there. Okay, again, two more through the top hole of the next Jim Duo. Picking up two more. And here we are coming out of this Jim Duo top hole. And again, I'm going to slide my beads down. And I'm going to need to go back into the hole of the metal connector, okay? Pardon me. Got to get my needle down in there. And go through. Oops. Now, I'm going to follow that same thread path and just reinforce everything we just added, okay? And it also helps stiffen up this whole component. So I went through the two seed beads, now the top of the Jim Duo, through the two seed beads. The top, well, I actually made it two seed beads, Jim Duo, and one other seed bead. So now I'm just going to go through the second seed bead, working our way around. Okay, here's where we're going to go through between the beads and go through the metal connector again. Then we're back up to the two seed beads, the top of the Jim Duo. Through the two seed beads, we're just going round as we go here. So I went through the Jim Duo as well with that stitch. Seed beads. And then back through between the diamond duo and the metal connector and into that hole again. All right. Now, for good measure, I'm going to take and go back into the center here and reinforce the center. So I'm going through this super duo, or excuse me, Jim Duo. Golly, mustn't confuse my beads here. If you can't get through two, just do one at a time. Okay, then do the next one. I came out on the underside of these seed beads, so I'm going to go behind the thread bridge there, and then I'm going to go back through the metal connector. It can hold one more pass of this fire line or wildfire or whatever you're using. And that is not included in the kit, okay? So you're going to have to, oops, I'm almost making a knot. I don't want to. There we go. You will have to provide your own beading thread. So we have a couple more to go here before we have circled all the way around. And this is becoming nice and stiff as we go. So here, I'm going to go ahead right here, and I'm going to catch this thread bridge, the one that's down at the bottom. I'm going to pull until I have a loop. I'm going to go through my loop and tie a knot right there, okay? I'm going to go through the next hole. And again, I'm going to catch that thread bridge right here. Pull it down till I have a loop. I'm going to go through that loop and I'm tying off there. See if we have enough room to go back through this one more time. And we do. So I'm going to go ahead and go through the next gem duo. And then I'm going to pick up the thread bridge again. Oops, thought I had it. There we go. Okay, I'm just holding on to everything and pulling that nice and tight. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to go through the next gem duo, not into the metal connector, just through the gem duo, like that. I'm going to go bring my thread from here up to these two 11-0s. And go through those. You just want to weave your way around when you're tying off. So I went through the gem duo and the next two seed beads. Going through the gem duo, the next two seed beads. And I'm going to tie off one more time right here. Okay. Again, I'm catching the thread bridge. Going through the loop once. Oops, I tied it on top of that bead and I did not want to. See if I can get that. I can almost see it. Yep, I can get it loose. So wherever you want to get your base thread, both of them in front of that seed bead here. There we go. So the knot doesn't tie over the silver, so there's that. Now I'm just going to tie off one more time, and that component piece is ready. We can go on to the lower half. Okay, there we go. Okay, again, once I find my thread zapper, I will use it. I'm going to carefully cut this off for the moment. This is why I say use the back of the scissors. Okay, so I will be able to get rid of that thread when I finally find me thread zapper. Okay, so I'm going to set this apart. And I'm going to set the needle down for a minute. We're going to get out the glue tray. And of course, my favorite glue, which is the Super Glue Gel Control by Loctite. I do not represent them. I just love this glue. Okay, just putting out a little bit because we don't need much. I'm going to get my dotting tool here. I'm going to zoom back out a little bit. And what we're going to do next is we're going to take our component and we're going to pick up some glue and put it on the bottom. Now use the big end to pick up more glue. And now to do the sides, I'm using the small end. And I'm just going to run it along the edges so our bead will not fall out. Okay. I'm going to pick, I carefully pick the ones that go in the center. I try to get the prettiest ones and lay it down in there and give it a good press, just like that. Super easy. Okay. All right. Now I'm going to go ahead and get some more wildfire. Another, don't really need a whole lot. I'm going to go back to the end of my scissors. Once again, I'm going to get the tip of this wet and pull it way down like that. Take my needle and just press it right on. It's super easy. Okay. All right. So, what we're going to do here is we're going to go, we're going to lay this down, and I'm going to take a Super Duo. Excuse me, I keep calling them Super Duos. These are Gem Duos. Let's zoom in a little bit here. I'm going to go through the hole on the connector, through the hole in the bead, and then through the hole on the other side of the connector. Okay, just like that. Again, I'm going to leave a little bit of a tail. Now, I am going to pick up two 11-0s, like that. I'm going to go from here, let's do three beads, 3 11-0s, then into the empty hole on the top of that Gem Duo. So we have, it fits between this hole and this hole, fits three beads really well. And I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. And we're going to go from here back to the hole and go through all of those again, just like that. So that is so easy. It's so pretty. Okay. I'm going to tie a little tiny knot right here for good measures. Keep that where I want it. Going to go back through these first three. Oh, I did it again. I can't wait till my glasses get here. I pulled my knot. I don't know if you can see it. You see the thread on top of that 11-0? So I was pulling my knot between the beads instead of in front of this bead. So I just pulled it out and made it tight. There we go. So now you can't see that thread anymore. Looks much better. Going through those three. Now I'm going to pick up three more. 1, 2, 3 more 11-0s. And I'm just going to go right back into the 3 11-0s on this side. If I can see well enough to do that. Yes, here we go. All right. So what this is doing is just wrapping it around. And here we're going to take and I'm going to tie off with my tail and my working thread and keep that knot in behind that last CV. Just like that. Okay. I'm going to go ahead and tie another for good measure for security purposes. Okay, and I'm going to go ahead and remove my tail. I'm going to go straighten out my thread here. I don't need any knots. I'm going to go back through this original pass. I'm going to go up 3 of these 11-0s here on the side. Okay, just 3. And I'm going to go through the top hole of the Gem Duo, just like that. Pull that through. And I'm going to go through the last, these. So I went through the 2. We're going through the 3 that we added last. Okay, so there's that. I'm going to go back through the gem duo. Okay, so I'm here, and now I'm going to go through these top three seed beads. Just like that. Okay, super easy. And now I am going to tie off right here. So I cut the thread bridge, get it down to where I have a nice loop, go through the loop, make sure that knot ties, is not tying over the bead. Okay, I'm going to go through all, through the metal component, the super duo, and out the other side, and I'm going to tie off here. Catch that thread bridge. Then bring my, I'm just going to work this through so I can hide the I don't want to tie any knots in the middle of seed beads, okay? So I did not go through that seed bead, or did I? I did not. All right, so I'm through these first two. I want to go through this third one right here. There we go. And then I'm going to take my thread. I'm just putting that needle through because I want that thread on the back side so I can cut it off right there. Okay. Now, all we have to do is connect the jump ring and the earring wire. That is a good looking earring, if I do say so myself. So I'm going to get my chain knobs, pliers here. I'm going to pick up that jump ring and I'm going to open it front to back. I'm going to pick up, I'm going to move it just a little. I'm going to pick this up by going front to back. Didn't open it enough, I guess. Open it a little more. Okay, front to back. And then on this, I'm going to go back to front. Okay, so they're both on there. It's a little tight, but you can get your, bring your jump ring and make sure it's closed properly. Like that, you know, and then what I like to do is spin it around so the opening is in the back, not the front. So easy. Then we're just going to open the jump ring on the ear wire. Now I'm going from front to back on the top piece so it's facing the direction that we need it to face. Then I'm going to close that back up and check it out. You've just made a really nice earring. Okay, I think that's so expensive looking. So what I would like to say next is that you can make these, but don't make them for sale. So I think I'll go ahead and copyright this little design. It's sweet. It's easy enough for beginners. And I hope that you have enjoyed today's project. These are up on the website for sale. And I have someone that's going to be shipping out these and these alone. So if you want this earring kit, you should order it separately. Because the person who's helping me while I'm gone, so I don't have all my beads out yet. I know where everything is. Well, most everything anyways, but she does not. So if you want the earring kit, order that. If you want to add to the order, just know you probably won't get it until November So I get home November 12th. So after that, okay? All right. I hope your week's going well. Be good to yourself, kind to others. Thank you so much for tuning in, and thank you for your support. It means so much to me. All right? Mwah. I'm Jill McKay signing off. I'll see you next time.